has been this bit of an introduction in which the bottom line is I began or I completed my MBA of sorts before most of you were born. So there's no way on earth I can relate to, where you guys are, okay? The brief to me was share experiences. I, for the past 8 or 10 years, after I set up my own entities, I've got a bunch of, young, smart MBAs, maybe slightly older than you, and often during our work-related interactions, they kind of tell me ki, sir, ye aapke generation ki baat nahi hai. So why don't you just chill out and let us do it? And I fully appreciate that. So I really don't have any clear, start points in terms of what to share or what not to share. The bottom line is you guys are amongst the top, whatever, 1 or 2% of this country, given the fact that you've gone into this institute and you're going to be busily doing an MBA. Based on the little experience which I have of working in the corporate world and the development sector, both in India and in some parts of the globe, what you can be assured is the moment you get out of here, the goodness of the world continues. It's basically each man on his own. The moment there are a group of six people at the same level working in a corporate, my experience, and this I say with some evidence across systems, including the Unilever system or the Ogilvy system or others where I worked in very large organizations. So each of those six roughly sensibly spends 30 to 40% of the time trying to work out methods to get ahead of the other five. Okay? And it's a fairly unjust kind of experience, which I suppose you all would sooner or later encounter and get used to. But before I keep on prattling on, I also sort of, as was shared in the introduction, have had an opportunity to, walk into places similar to the school, be it MDI, BIMTEC. You heard of those names? Absolutely top of mind. I am Indore to deliver gyan on my area. So, and like all old people, I have this habit of going on and on. So what I was thinking was, as a start point, in case there are any questions, anything which any of you may like me to share a view, or if you'd like to share a view on something, you're more than welcome. Or am I going to get utter deathly silence? And any thoughts at all about what you would like to cover in the session? Any questions, any areas? I'm old, so I'm very patient. 50 साल हो गए और 20-30 साल जिंदगी निकालने हैं तो मैं यहीं खड़े रहूंगा। हमारे जमाने में क्लास पार्टिसिपेशन बोला करते थे। एट टाइम्स इवन इफ यू डिडंट हैव अ क्वेश्चन, कम अप विद अ क्वेश्चन, कीप द गाय ऑन द डायस हैप्पी, और एल्स आई वुड स्टार्ट क्विजिंग। कम ऑन गाइस, गिव मी अ ब्रेक, गिव मी अ स्टार्ट पॉइंट। यस प्लीज। In hospitality, that's probably some other Sata group. We work in the area of So one, this laughter, you see, this is just the beginning. I told you, na, you're one out of the six, the remaining five, the moment the opportunity comes, pull him down. Yeah, we work in the area of advertising and research. So in both, actually, concepts are developed. So advertising, wo sabun tel agar bechna ho, so you can position it on, on freshness, on the fragrance of the soap, on the fact that the soap simply lasts longer. Okay, now once you decide on that, then you develop alternate ways to render the creative. So yes, we do concepts. Okay, but that's some other side. Okay, let me ask, maybe I begin with the gentleman in the, hi, your name? Jai Singh.
What do you see, getting out of the course, and what do you plan to kind of do after you get out of here? Any thoughts? I'm just trying to find anchors, you know, sir. Maybe then I could respond within. Cool. Okay. May I have a statement from the lady in the center? One next to the gentleman in the green shirt.
I haven't decided anything yet. So I will go through my course and then I will decide.
Okay. What's your name?
Tanushree.
Tanushree. Okay. And can we move a bit further back, please? This time let's go to a guy with a green shirt. Sorry, not you, but there's somebody else a couple of rows behind. Mayank.
Yes, sir.
Uh-huh. Could you speak a little louder, please? Okay. Any thoughts on what you'd like to sort of do after getting out of here?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Manage the risks. Fair enough. Could we just go absolutely to the last row? Should I carry the mic around? My vote is always for the backbenchers. Okay. So in HR, what kind of organization, what kind of a functional area within HR? Okay, great. So thank you. Your name? Parul. Okay. Great. Would have loved to. Yeah. Yes, please. Oh, great. You are my favorite person. What's your name? Great, Rakesh. Yeah. Okay. Fine. You topped your batch earlier. Okay. This bit about realizing goals. It's actually extremely tricky. I'm sure a hell of a lot of you would probably be thinking about it, and there'll be a lot of people around you who, I mean, at least during my college days, I was constantly hauled up. Aage jaake kya karoge? Focus on this or focus on that. What I've found over a period of time is that, at least for me, it was easier for me as I got along to understand maybe what I did not want to get into. So, with all due respect to the gentleman in the corner, after my first term in IRMA, and I sort of almost flunked a couple of finance quizzes, there used to be these horrible projections of income flow and stuff, and that's why in the business also that's a huge challenge. But then I realized probably finance is not up my alley. At the same time, marketing, you know, with positioning and all, it left to me a lot of room to, you know, just imagine and create. So, one way I sort of pegged it was, I'm sorry, I'm answering your question in a slightly roundabout manner. First, addressing the bit about, you know, the goal definition. But what I think is, again, I mean, this is a top-down statement. You could take it or leave it. But what I think and I believe and what I've experienced is that at least in the short run or the immediate term, very, very important to have a clearly defined, you could call it a goal, you could call it an objective. It could be on any, you know, kind of, yardstick. I'll conclude this long statement by answering your question. Okay. For example, HR or, you know, finance, you probably, I mean, within a group, you would have a few students who would, at this point of time and maybe a little bit on also, you know, possibly thinking that let's first experience and you know, we'll probably do an internship, whatever, थोड़ा बाद में decide करेंगे. And whereas the others have probably decided on a field to an extent, what actually works beautifully is that maybe once you're through with a couple of semesters, you know, if you've actually sort of targeted your the kind of organization, have a list A, B, C, the kind of functional area, all it does is that it increases the possibility of your reaching there. Okay, I mean, in our days, there used to be a saying, garbage in, garbage out, or rather fuzziness in and fuzziness out. So it's something like, you know, getting out of your homes to come to the institute. If you know you're headed to the institute, you know, you might reach there 10 minutes late or 5 minutes ahead, but you definitely will reach there. Okay, so I am in favor of, you know, at least some immediate term goals. And within that, one way of deciding, the way I apply it is that I put my landscape and then, hey, this is what I don't want to do, this is what I don't want to do, that sounds interesting. And then probably work within that. As far as Irma goes, my management school, I think it made all the difference in my life. To begin with, I wouldn't be here if I didn't have that MBA degree. But more importantly, I did most of my, you know, career has been in rural. I think the one big difference which I felt then as a graduate, but you guys are much more empowered and much more alive. I mean, in our generation, we're just having a discussion with Mr. Prasad and this thing. We just did not ask too many questions. Okay, you guys are much more connected. So probably the horizons have changed. But I think in Stevens, it was one happy song and dance. Okay, we used to kind of get into classes as we wished to. The college festival was terribly important. Delhi, you see, those days had one cinema hall which had a, which used to show English films, Chanakya. And one of my very close buddies, he still remains that, belonged to an industrial household. He used to have a lot of money. He had a car at his disposal and he was the most studious. So we used to take the car keys, get out for the late night movie, and then eat at a dhaba at Ramjas at about 2 a.m. And then, so that's what life was about. Now, the moment I got into Irma, the first term I was writing actually letters home to dad, you know, informing him that the academic rigor is just not there, and writing home to mom. And those days we used to have letters, you know, the snail mail, about the fact that khana theek nahi mil raha, you know, me and a number of other batchmates, because in Irma we got in as 93 and 63 got out. You know, the kind of huge shift on the academic rigor was tremendous. I'm sure some of you will experience that here as well. So it did bring a sense of I would call it a certain discipline, which has usually helped me in the workplace subsequently, about, you know, that you need to apply yourself consistently. There are also a lot of situations wherein one came across case studies and courses, which you would find here as well, in which either the case situation itself just becomes Latin and Greek. You know, for example, if I, you know, was to conduct a session right now on maybe what's the appropriate marketing strategy for one variant of Lifebuoy in the context of rural Andhra, and give you some compounded annual growth rate and half a dozen figures, it might well be, you know, just blue space. So you sort of get used to managing those spaces, and that also sort of really helps. Contextually, that rural exposure, I mean, I got to see the country and after that I stayed with it, really. So have worked in the rural domain for a very long time. Above all, I think management education gives a very useful learning on how to look at a problem. You know, define the problem, define the constraints, how to address it. So these are very many ways, I think, in which the Irma education helped me. Have I at all responded to your question, or has it just been too vague? Okay. A pleasure.
Aha. Okay, cool. Yes, please, ma'am. She said you, so you. If you say her, then her. Good morning. Anisha.
That's what my faculty used to say once upon a time, but they never got the answer. Sorry. Sorry, I'm having fun.
Anisha, I love you for Googling my name. What I can assure you is that out of all B school graduates, and you take it for a given amongst this group out here, once they spend 25 years in the industry, sabka naam Google karo, kuch na kuch cheeze aayengi. As far as the specific label goes, Rural Man of India, I think that was accorded by somebody somewhere. It's really got nothing to do with what I do. When I got into rural and into rural marketing, probably there were not too many people. However, I guess what does count, and then maybe that's something which you all could make as a part of your kitty, is, and it's probably more relevant in today's existence. You see, hamare zamane mein, if there was a group of people working, baitho na, there used to be these, have you heard of the strong, silent, handsome guy, right? So there used to be these strong, silent chaps sitting and busily working away. Then there used to be others who used to be gabbing all the time, okay? And during those days, somehow wisdom, sincerity were attributes which were sort of automatically connoted to somebody who probably was not speaking too much. Okay, luckily, I believe there's some rationalization which has happened in the corporate place, but at the same time, it's also changed to the extent that the cycle times today in the corporate world are probably much lesser than, you know, what they were during our time. Pink slips were unheard of. You're familiar with the term pink slip? Huh? Miss HR, at the back. Huh? People get fired, okay? In the US and a lot of other economies, I mean, that was the case for a very long time, and it was accepted. I mean, you were told to leave because of whatever reasons, and you just simply went on to the next assignment. In India, there was a huge bit of a social, you know, stamp on it, a stigma associated. A, that has changed. B, because the way the global economies are emerging, if any of you have traveled to Japan or would travel to Japan, the traditional Japanese companies, till a few years back, the culture was you joined and you stayed. The head of the company was more like a family head, and there were a lot of rituals within the organization. The bottom line was nobody really moved out. It was just beyond thinking there. Now, pink slips are starting to happen there as well. Sony Corporation, others, they're all downsizing, left, right, center. So within all of that, therefore, I believe for today's generation, as you guys get out there, you just have that much time to demonstrate your performance, okay? So that would really amount to what I would strongly suggest is focus on building your communication skills, both on these boxes as well as verbally. Try and engage as soon as possible with, people, areas in your sector which are outside the normative which you're exposed to basis your routine. Now, what do I mean by the latter bit? For example, somebody wishing to specialize in HR, you have site HR, you have half a dozen of these forums which can all be accessed on the net. You know, so over the next 2 years, as you do your B-School, it's not about, slogging. I could be wrong. I'm strictly against that. Okay. But small incremental units, probably spend an hour in a week to begin with on just getting on a couple of sites in your area of interest, professional forums, start engaging. By the time you actually get out, you probably would have created a path of entry for yourself into an organization. You would have picked up hell of a lot of stuff in terms of information, knowledge, experience. And it's really not about swatting it for those 8 to 10 hours, okay? So linking with this thought, what I'm really sharing is about visibility to forums beyond, your sort of normative sphere of interaction. So therefore, how the Rural Man of India thing happened was I used to be working in this outfit in which I had a kind boss, and he was concerned about the financials. So as long as the numbers came, he let me be. So I used to write articles. I used to conduct workshops for a few corporates on this entire rural business. I used to go to B schools like this. Somewhere in